If you are in a situation where you're reading so hard and you're still failing, or you read so well but you find it difficult to remember what you've read, trust me, this video is for you. This series is
for you. Hi, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Jemima. You're welcome. I'm happy to have you here. So today we're going to be talking about study tips, you know, tips for effective study. To start with, I'm a medical student studying medicine in Nigeria. Yeah, actually, Nigeria. Yes, I know. And apart from that, I have a B.Sc degree in human anatomy. In this video, I'm going to tell you what changed. I'll tell you what I did that made me to jump from being a 30, 40, 50 student into becoming a 60 and 70 student. In medical school in Nigeria, having a 60 or a 70, it's a very, very big deal. So if you want to know how I started having 60s and 70s in my medical school exams, watch this video, it's for you. There are so many tips, so many, trust me. I have, but I would cut this video into different parts, because if I'm to tell you all the tips in this same video, it's going to be too long. I wouldn't want to bore you. So the first tip I'm going to tell you about is start early. Start early. I cannot overemphasize. You don't have to wait until the exam timetable is out for you to start studying. Like, geez, you would not want to do that. Trust me. I would use myself as a case study. What I do is, when I attend my classes and come back that day, I make sure I don't sleep until I finish reading up everything I learned that day. Don't allow these things pile up. Don't let your schoolwork pile up. Read every day. In my first degree, I used to wait until exam timetable is out for me to do real serious studying, and that made me crash, like crash. That kind of crashing that you enter exam hall and you're discovering new topics. You know, that's what I'm talking about. What? When I got into my MBBS degree, I discovered I can't continue like that. I can't do that anymore. This is what I started doing, and it worked for me so well. What I started doing, or let me say, what I do now is, when I go for classes and come back, you know, I freshen up, take my bath, get something to eat, you know, check my social media handles and stuff like that, just for probably the first hour after I come back from school. And the next thing I do is to read. I gather my materials together for all the classes I had that day, all the topics that I have that I had that day. Go through them. Just go through it using fast reading. I'm going to release a video on how to do fast, effective fast reading. That's what I do. So fast reading, flip through, get used to let your brain get used to the terms, let your brain get used to the words. These are probably things that you've never seen before, especially if the MBBS degree that you're reading is your first degree. So if you're studying for 6 years and that's your first degree, it means that's the first time that you're seeing anatomy and physiology and biochemistry. You would not want to wait for exam period to read it, to start reading anatomy, or you want to start reading biochemistry week before exam. Hey, the way you will fail, eh? Even your village people will be shocked. I'm serious. So what I do, I come back, I make sure I don't sleep until I go through those materials. Seriously. So you don't have to be me. Someone like me, I don't read at night. I'm not the type that would say I will sleep and wake up at night to read. If I close my eyes to sleep, next time I open my eye is the next morning, and geez, I cannot make such a mistake. So know yourself, know what works for you. If you're the type that can sleep and wake up later at night, well, that's nice, perfect, good for you. You come back from school and freshen up, do your social media, whatever you want to do after school, and then you sleep, wake up later at night, go through everything that you learned that day. And if you're like me, that once you sleep, next time you open your eyes the next morning, then make sure you read through everything you've learned that day before you close your eyes to sleep. Okay, start early. Start your reading early. If you are the type who waits for exam timetable to be out to read, yes, you're going to tell me that your brain works very well under pressure. Yes, I know your brain works very well under pressure. You that started reading a week to exam,
can't compare yourself to the person who have been reading right from day one. You will overstress yourself. And exam period, to me, in my own opinion, it's not the time for you to get stressed. It's a time for your brain to get enough rest, because if your brain is not well rested enough, you can enter the exam hall and forget a lot of things. Yes, you can jumble up the words, but if you start reading early enough, there will be a build-up of memory. The material that you'll be able to retain, it will be built up in such a way that you won't jumble up the words. Jumbling up of words, it happens when you put your brain under marathon reading. You're trying to, just like you're trying to force an information on your brain. Your brain needs time, enough time to be able to gather whatever information and retain whatever information that you're feeding it with. And when you start early enough, it gives your brain that opportunity to adjust and get used to these words, get familiar with these words.
Let me just quickly tell you a short story of what happened to me when I was in my first degree. So, like I said, I used to wait for exam timetable to be out to do serious studying. And there was this course that I read so much. I read so hard. I think that was histochemistry. And it was so voluminous that I started jumbling up words. That's what happens. Do you know, the night before that exam, I stayed away from 12 a.m., read till 6 a.m. when I got to school. The exam was shifted from 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. Imagine, and I have not slept. Do you know, I stayed awake till that 1 p.m. And when I entered the exam hall, my brain was blank. I could not remember anything in that course. Oh, I spoke in tongues. I prayed all manner of prayers that I could pray. I couldn't remember anything. So that's what happens when you overwork your brain and your brain doesn't get enough rest. Exam period is not a time to overstress your brain. It's a time to get enough rest. That's why I brought up that story, because it happened to me, and since then I learned my lesson the bitter way, like the hard way. This one is not bitter, it's hard. Since then, I start my reading early, so that exam period, when others are struggling and stressing their brain and all that, that's the time that you're giving your brain rest. And when your brain is well rested during that exam period, trust me, your brain will cooperate with you in exam hall if there's any language like that. But when you overstress it that exam period, your brain will wait for you. And in exam hall, it will show you back all the stress. So that's by the way, on the lighter notes. My point is, let your brain be well rested during exam period so that in exam hall, your brain will work with full capacity and give you all the information that you need to write that exam and get your 60s and 70. So that's the point. Start early. Second tip is repetitive reading. I cannot, this is my number two on the list. You can't read something once and you expect to remember up to even 40% to be able to write an exam, except of course you read that thing just before you entered the exam hall. But with how voluminous the course outline is, you can't tell me that you will read everything in the course outline just before entering exam hall. Now, I'm not talking about cheating or exam malpractice in a case where you already know what you're going to be asked. I'm not talking about that. We are Jesus babies here. We don't do such things. That's by the way. My point is, you need to read over and over again. Like me, I go through whatever is the course outline for that semester. I go through it at least 4 times before I enter exam hall, so that I will be able to remember up to 60 to 70 to 80% to be able to write an exam. Imagine, 4 times. No, think about it. Just take 1 second or 2 seconds to think about it. If you read something 4 times, there is no how that your brain will not be able to remember, except there's a problem somewhere that may be spiritual or you have a health issue. There's no how your brain will not be able to remember that thing that you've read at least 4 times. It's not possible. So let me tell you how I do my own reading at least 4 times to be able to write an exam. This is what I do.
for my first reading. That same day I come back from school, I go through everything I was taught that day. If the lecturers gave materials, I go through it that same day. Or if any material at all, any slide or any material that I received that day, I make sure I go through it that same day. That's my first reading. And like I said in the first point, fast reading. The second time I go through that material is the next morning, before I leave my lodge or my hostel for classes that morning. I make sure I take probably the first 1 hour or 2 hours, depending on how early I wake up that morning. For all the courses that I have that day, I make sure I go through the previous topics, whatever I was taught in the last class. I go through it to refresh my memory so that wherever the lecturer will start from for that day, I will be able to pick up. For example, if you're having a biochemistry class that day and in the previous class you learned about hemoglobinopathies, when I wake up that morning, I read through that material, or I read through whatever I jotted down, or I read through whatever slide I downloaded from SlideShare, so that it would help my memory. Now that's the second time I'm reading that material. Take note of that. For the third time, weekends. Oh my God, I don't joke with my weekends. My weekends are very important to me. So weekends, yes, I understand that you could be very busy on weekends. You know, weekends for me, I use my weekends to socialize with my friends. I use my weekends to rest properly. I use my weekends for church. I use my weekends for my politics, several personal capacity building projects. That's what my weekends are for. But I still try to create time to do some studying during weekends. So during weekends, what I do is I study everything I learned that week. If I am so busy that I don't have enough time to do serious studying, I use fast reading just to go over everything I learned for the week. Note that this is the third time I'm reading those things, so this time around, it won't be as difficult as when you went through it the first time. And that's the third time that I'm reading that material. The fourth time I go through that material again is when timetable comes out finally. By that time, oh, adrenaline. The fear of the exam will make your brain to work faster and would increase your assimilation rates, you get. So you can imagine when you finally do serious studying on that fourth time, with the background you've given your brain already, that you've read that same thing three times. Like, why won't you understand? Why won't your brain be able to remember it? And if you still have time, the fifth time is the night before your exam. You go through it again. If you're like me who don't read at night, just before you sleep, you go through it. Or if you're someone that can sleep and wake up at night, you do that. So the night before your exam, you read through that material again the fifth time. And then if you still have time, you read it through again the sixth time on the morning before your exam. Repetitive reading is something that you just have to do. You have to go over it over and over and over again. Whatever you want your brain to get used to, you need to read it through. You need to get used to the terms. You need to get used to the words. Repetitive reading. By next week, next weekend, by latest next week Sunday, the part two of this video will be out with more tips for you to have effective study habits. Trust me, these are tips that I've done and it worked for me. If you've watched this video to this point, I am so grateful. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked this video, please give this video a thumbs up. And if you like this content and you want to see more, please subscribe to my channel. I am ready to share all these tips with you, because one thing I love so much is I love seeing people rise up from whatever situation that they found themselves. So like I said, expect the part two of this video next week. Bye. That's 6 a.m. I went. I didn't take my bath. I mean, sorry. I said try to read through what made me to stop. I have done this. And